Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? Right, I'm just hitching up the front weight and then we're going to get our little road train that we got over there. We have a field over there that is ready to harvest. The rest of our land isn't yet ready to harvest. I'd like to go and feed the pigs before we start doing our combining and stuff. And that'll also give a chance for the rest of the corn to come ripe. We've just got field 14 ready at the moment. Field 19 and our two extra bits up here, they're not ready to go yet. So that is... yeah, if we go and feed the pigs first, then by the time we've done that one, hopefully these two or three other ones will be ready to go. At least that's what I'm hoping. Now, we've got enough corn here for the pigs. I was saying that I would like to increase our number of pigs so that we can get to our target of 100 on here faster. I now know from the time-lapse series, if you've been following that, that it's just, I think it's around 120 pigs will give you a reproduction rate of 1 per hour. It might be slightly more than that, might be like 140. At the moment, we're on 1 every 6.5 hours. And we're on 95, this is on 95% productivity. So I think at 100% productivity, it's actually close to like 120 pigs or something. But if we get 100 pigs, then our reproduction rate is definitely going to be lower than an hour and a half. It'd be about an hour and 20, I would imagine, something like that. So what we'll end up with is between 15 and 20 pigs that we can sell every single day, which is an absolute huge number. And I don't think the price of animals fluctuates at all. It doesn't look like it does. If you look through here, you've got the different rates for all different things, but it doesn't look like there's anything for animals, so I don't think that they fluctuate. Anyway, I will get this hitched up, and as it was pointed out last time, that I shouldn't have the turntable trailer on the front, because if I brake heavily, it could cause it to jackknife quite easily, and everything will tip over, so we do want to try to avoid doing that. We can have the water bowser on the back, that we do know. It's a gravity water bowser. It doesn't have a pump or use a PTO in any way. It's simply just a gravity fed tanker, so we can change that round. But what we are going to do is we're going to put our trailers in the correct order for road safety. We don't want to risk having a nasty accident, so just swap to that one, I think. Yep, there we go. And oh no, I want to, am I going to be able to back up? I haven't changed. Yes, perfect, look at that. Right, I do that, and I want to actually change it to the back one. I want to take that one off, and then I want to come forward, and I want to take that trailer off, which I'll do now. Then I want to bring this one, and we want to put the turntable trailer onto the other one. Before I do that a minute, my question that I can sort of do and read at the same time, my question that I asked you all last week was, should I get square or round balers? Now, or balers, a square or a round baler, I should say. We're not getting multiples. I'm not going to be able to get it immediately. It's going to be a little while. So the straw from the next couple of harvests, at least, we'll probably just be gathering up, if there is any, with the Pottinger forage wagon. But when I do, we had exactly 1,600 responses to the question, which is a huge number of responses. And 258 of you thought that I should go for round bales. Just 258. Everybody else, all 1,342 other responses that we had, said square bales. So it is square bales that we're going for. Just want to go to that one. There we go. Spin round, and now we can get this trailer and put it on the front. This should be the safest configuration. We can't put anything on behind the water bowser, so that one does need to go on the back. But these other two trailers, we put them this way round, should minimize the chance of anything nasty happening while we're on the road, and hopefully keep us safe. Right, let me just back up here. So we're doing square bales. The people that wanted round bales, mainly it was because of the silage, because it is an option for extra money. And yes, I agree, it would be a good option to get us some extra money, but at the moment we don't really need it. We have other incomes. You probably noticed my income has gone up a bit. I did a couple of extra jobs in between episodes, and that's earned us a little bit more. But that brings us on to my next question, which is in baling technology. We've got all these different things with the bales, so we will be getting that one there for 102,000 euros at some point. So my question for this week is, When I come to gathering up bales, do you want me to get the Arcusin here, which will gather up 16 bales, fully automated, and bring them back to the yard and stack them? It does everything. It's a beautiful, wonderful trailer. Magnificent. Can't fault it. Or would you like me to get the small Arcusin, which just does a stack of 3 bales, and then you can either use that one to drag them back to the yard, or you could get something like that trailer there and manually load them onto that trailer with a front loader and a bale spike, and then bring them back and then subsequently unload them. I will probably have a go at both. So if I do get that one, I'll do some front loader work from the field back to the yard. And if I get that one, it'll just be the front loader work while we're back here at the yard. But it's your vote, it's your game. Do you want the 16 bale Arcusin, or do you want the 3 bale Arcusin? There should be a vote card come up here. I know I've forgotten them a couple times now, but hopefully it'll be up there so you can cast your vote. Head into the comment section down below. Let us know why you're voting for the one that you're voting for, and see if you can't persuade someone else to vote for the same one that you have. Now then, I think we'll use up the rest of the wheat first, and then we'll... I don't think we're going to... Actually, let's just take a look at the numbers that we've got up with the pigs. I don't think we're going to need more. Wheat and barley, 14. Yeah, we're not going to need more than that. Let's go on to the next one. I'll take corn, and then the last one I'll... I don't know if I'll do that today. Well, we got canola. Oh, no, we want corn. So we got canola. We'll be getting some beans now. We're going to keep some of it for our pigs, but we're not going to keep all of it. Some of it I would like to sell. We've got loads of beans everywhere. I still haven't been able to do the video that I did say that I would try to do. From the map that a fan sent to me, where he'd set everything up ready to do the full investigation into how it all works, and what the yields and everything are, is beautifully set up. There's a lot of work that's gone into doing it, and I just haven't been able to get the time yet to go and do it, to sort of give the map the justice that it deserves. And I'm really sorry about that. I know that the person who sent it to me does watch most of my episodes. I haven't forgotten about it, and I will do it when I can, so that we can sort of get some, you know, I can show the answers. But I have looked it up. I've looked up and done quite a bit of research about it. Now what we're going to do here is we're just going to drive straight into the river with this point that we can cross over and spin round, and then we can just fill that tanker up while we're in here. We should hopefully... Oh, no, I want to go... If I go there... There, now it's letting us fill. So we can fill straight from the river like this, which is perfect. You've got to sort of stay still for a bit because you will have stirred up a bit of silt and sediment. So once you drive into the river, just pause for a moment to allow the silt to wash away. Then you can fill your tanker and you won't run into any trouble. I really do like using the... Well, I like using any road trains. I'm quite a big fan of road trains. I did get rid of the road train in the time-lapse series lately, purely because of the way that you sell things in the game. I'd like to try and find a bigger road train with bigger trailers on it. I think that would be awesome. I think that would just... Yeah, it just makes it for me. I absolutely love driving around with road trains. It's just so much fun. Well, I tell you what. I will meet you up at the pigs. We will put some food in for them, we'll put some water in for them, then we'll go back and we'll get the Kramer, and we'll put one of these trailers onto the Kramer and whiz up with the last bit of corn, and we can also spoon a little bit of straw in for them. It's not the strongest of tractors, so it doesn't really like going uphill when it's got anything resembling weight behind it, but once you're going along the straight, or rather, better still, going slightly downhill with the wind behind you, it doesn't do too bad pace, really. To be honest, it reminds me of one of my first cars. Actually, it reminds me of a lot of cars that I've owned over the years. They're not so good going uphill, but if you go downhill and you have the wind behind you, you can get a good turn of speed out of them. 30, sometimes even 40 miles an hour. Yes. Okay, moving swiftly on. Let's just stick some water in for the pigs here. Now, I reckon that if we were to get a couple trailer loads of pigs with the stock trailer that we got, I can't remember how many pigs it holds now, but yeah, if we could just get like a couple trailer loads, we'd be looking at... Hang on, I want to... Oh no, I want an eye to unload, don't I? So put that in there. There we go. I think two trailer loads would be enough I don't think we need more than that. Now, this one, if I can just come up here behind that one, is timing it, because this thing doesn't stop. It tries to drive underneath the trailers, which is a little bit of a nuisance. It's one aspect of this machine that I don't particularly like. But we can tip there. Right, that's not going to let me tip anymore. And then I come up here and I tip that one. It's not very realistic doing it like this. But look, see, now look at that. He's completely gone in the wrong direction because he's got wrapped around the trailer. I really should switch it off before I start trying to use it. Come here, you. Let's turn it off, or at least turn off the hired help. I'll move him back over here out the way a minute. Now, if we whiz over here, I'm going to have to spin round because we're going to be running back to the yard in a minute. There we go. This trailer doesn't have... You don't turn as sharp as the trailer would technically allow you to turn in real life on this one. So it doesn't have much of a turning circle, whereas the turntable trailer on the front, that has a tighter turning circle. A little bit disappointing, that. Oh well. Now, what do we got for the pigs? So, therefore, the straw... Actually, the straw is nearly full. Canola and sunflowers, we've got several days' worth on that, so... I don't think we need to worry about it at the moment. I think... probably we'll be all right. Actually, what we could do is when we get a trailer load of beans from the land that is just over, it's very close to us. It's actually, if you look at the little arrow on the minimap now, I'm pointing, it's literally just over the top of this hill, one of our new fields. So we could actually just use that, and that'll be okay for setting up, that'll be okay for feeding our pigs. Now, gonna have to reset this one. He's a bit sensitive when it comes to getting it in the right direction. That looks to be about right, I think. So if I go there and then I press H, that will set it off again. That's perfect. So we're not going to need to worry about coming up here just yet because we've got plenty of straw. Oh, there was one more thing I wanted to do, because I think it's 9 pigs that we take in the trailer, isn't it? Did we start out with 18 pigs? No, I'm not too sure now. But if we go here... they cost 3,000 a time, so if we can get 9 pigs into that stock trailer, I'm going to have a look. Yeah, 3,000 a time, that is $27,000 if we were to get 9 in there. I can't remember if it is or it isn't. I've got a feeling it doesn't actually tell us how many. Yeah, it just says that you can carry those, but it doesn't tell us how many that we can take. We don't actually find out until you try to load them up, which is an absolute nuisance. I would really like to know. But that doesn't really matter because we have to buy the fields first. Everybody said you wanted me to buy those two fields first, so that's what we're going to do. But what I'm going to do now, because we don't need to worry about the rest of it. We don't need to worry about the straw at the moment. We'll head on. I'm going to do this from in cab this time. You can see my driving. I was trying to drive sideways so that I could look at the road train, and I drifted a bit. Just press escape here a minute. Right, the cows, straw is actually low on the cows and the power food. So what we'll do is we'll put some more of that in. We'll put a bit more of the power food in. It should be a bit quicker loading it up this time. Now that we know what we're doing. And we'll put... how did we do it last time? I think we did 2 buckets. We did 2 buckets of each, didn't we? And it ended up being too much straw. So we'll do 2 buckets of each. 2 buckets of silage, 2 buckets of hay, and 1.5 buckets of straw. And then we'll spoon a bit of straw into them as well, so that it'll top them right up with power food and we won't need to worry about them for a few days. I would like to get those done as well. I know we're going to... After we've bought the fields, I'd like to buy a few more of those. Top them up. We should get a better income coming in from those as well. Anyway, we'll get to that. That's a little ways down the line right now. But for now, if we get it all topped up, then we don't need to worry about them while we do our harvest and do all of our planting. I'm not going to plant the same crop across the whole lot this next time round. I'll probably do half and half. We'll do 2 crops. We'll definitely do one that gives us a bit of straw, so that we've got some straw to deal with. I quite like dealing with straw, even if it's just to gather it up and sell it. Because it does actually make a decent bit of profit being able to sell straw. And then the other one, I'm not sure yet. It won't be root crops, I know that much. It's not going to be root crops. And just come forward a little bit further. Actually, I just pressed unhitch. That wasn't very useful. Hang on. Let me come out of cab. I keep pressing the wrong button on here now. Which one did I want to do? If I come back a bit, is that going to let me hitch on? Yes. Right, now if I come forward, and I can unhitch. It's because in FS15 it was the same button for both. Unhitch and tip were both on the same button, and I had them mapped to the same. So I've still got unhitch mapped to the same button on my steering wheel. However, because unhitch is no longer the same as tip, I've got that on a different button on my steering wheel, and I still haven't gotten used to it. Do you understand? Good. Maybe you could explain it to me, because I'm not sure that I do. Right. So, yeah, I think we might do some more corn and do that with our combine. I'm not quite sure yet. I'm still sort of thinking about that. But anyway, we're going to need the trailers. We won't really need two trailers down here. We'll only really need the one. In fact, I'm going to leave the turntable trailer here somewhere. I'll leave them both here for a minute because we've got to start loading up the machine. Hang on. Come to the front. There we go. Right. Now, I'm going to go over here. I'll tell you what, I will go and get this hitched up, and then I'll get the Kramer over there, and we can start spooning in a bit of hay, and then we can tip it in for the cattle. I've got one bucket of straw here, and then we'll spoon two buckets of hay in. Go and get a couple buckets of silage as well and tip that in. And we probably actually... Well, we could do it with just one bucket of straw. The only real reason to use straw is to bulk it out a bit, because it's the cheapest item. So you sort of bulk it out with a bit of straw in order to save money. That's the main reason to use the straw. But it's not actually required. The hay and the silage is required, though. It's just a little point to it. It's worth remembering if you're doing your own. Come around here. You don't need the straw if you're struggling. So it also means that you can still feed the power food, the total mixed ration, to your cattle, even if you don't have a supply of straw. You don't have the bedding available, and it does mean that you don't get any manure. So you do kind of need a bit of straw for that. Let me just come back here. Always need water. They also require a clean feeding area, and some require straw. Don't know. If we were to let the straw run right out, would it stop the productivity altogether? Obviously, the water, if water goes, you got zero productivity. You have to have water in for the animals. They will not go without it. But do they do the same with straw, or do they just not have a clean bedding area? Because I know that some farmers, they don't actually bed their animals at all. They don't give them any bedding. And the way that they house the animals, it sort of works a little bit differently. I know one farmer that actually, he doesn't put bedding down for his cattle. He actually uses sand, and he spreads sand on their sleeping area, and they'll sleep there. And even when they've got the yard is open in the summer, because sometimes the way that his farm works, basically it's an option for the cows. If they choose to, they can either sleep outside in fields, which a lot of cows do anyway. Most cows would do that in the summer, or they can go inside and sleep in the just in cubicle stalls, so that they can walk in and out at will. They have straw, not straw, sorry. They have the sand that's sort of spread over it, and he spreads it through there once a week at most. And they will still choose to go in and lie down on that rather than sleep in the field, which genuinely surprised me. It did surprise me when I first heard of it, but now that I've sort of, you know, experienced a few different places that different conditions that animals sleep in and so on, doesn't really surprise me all that much. It's surprising where animals do go and sleep. You see them sleep in some very odd and peculiar places. And so, yeah, he would get this sand, and he would spread it in their cubicles once a week, I think it was. And you know the rotor spreaders, the old muck spreader? I did use one in the, not the old times Let's Play, the other one, the higher hills, where I was using smaller machinery. I used a rotor spreader in that one, and he just had one of those, and that's what he would put the sand in with. Spread the sand with that one right across all the cubicles. He'd only have to drive down one side, spread sand across the whole area. He would muck it all out beforehand, use the scraper and scrape out, and then go down through, and he would spread sand, and there's one alleyway up through the middle of how his cubicles were, and then there was an alleyway on right on each side, and it was only the middle alleyway that would get sand on it when he was doing the spreading, and he would just go down through with the I can't remember what he did. I think he had like a it was some sort of it was a type of mechanical brush. It was one of those angled road sweepers, and he would just go down through with that one because the sand was clean and it was on clean concrete, because he did this right after scraping out. Then he'd go along with a shovel and just shovel that last little bit up. And it does sound a little bit labour intensive just doing that last little bit, and it was to a certain extent. But generally, it was all right. It was quick, it was efficient, and it was also very clean. It was only very, very small amounts of sand got kicked out into the channels during the day, into the dung channels, and that would just get scraped up with all the manure. And it worked really well. I was quite surprised at that. Especially when I first heard that he beds his animals with sand. I thought, well, that's not very nice. You know, that's you know, how can you bed your animals with sand? That just doesn't seem right. But yeah, it worked really well. Right, we're slowly running out of time here. I did want to at least get the combine started today. We don't look like we're going to do that. So we will bed our animals down. And I'm going to try, very carefully, to put half of this in here. Let's come on round. Right, I only want to put about 900 litres of this in. So I've got to just tip carefully. So I don't want to do it too fast. And then I've got to get ready to tilt it back the other way. There we go. Right, so I've got about 900 litres in there. That should... Yes, look at that. We don't have... It's just right. Okay, so it's a bucket and a half of straw and two buckets of silage and two buckets of hay. We could probably fit three buckets of silage, three hay and two straw in. I would think that we could fit that in there. I know that we can. Didn't we actually fit three hay, two silage and two straw? I think we did. Right, we need to turn the thing on so that it mixes. We look at that. It turns these giant paddles inside. And as I have said so many times before, I really, really wish that in this game they would actually introduce it that you had to put corn and stuff like that in. Places I've worked, we would have put barley in here. We would have put... one place I worked, I had this huge great big tank of molasses that they would put in. And they would put in a couple gallons of molasses as well and mix all that in. Oh, it used to smell heavenly. The smell of the silage mixed with the molasses was just awesome. It was so, so good. You wouldn't believe. Just opening a tin of black treacle. I think you actually call it molasses in the States, but we call it... Because you can eat it. It's quite acceptable for humans to eat it. You buy it off the shelf in the supermarket. We call it black treacle. So, yeah, you open up a tin of black treacle, and it smells just the same. Oh, it's absolutely wonderful. It's genuinely wonderful. It really is. And it really brings back that smell of... It just reminds me of the smell of the two mixed together. And I used to love that. Right. We've put the entire tank full in. How much have we got here? So it's filled up that. Where is it all going? Because we never had that much missing, did we? Okay, so 8,500 apart. I'm sure we didn't put that much. I should have looked at the numbers before I started tipping this stuff in. I know that that was only like half full, but I'm pretty sure silage and hay was completely full. So yeah, it does appear that power food... I don't know how this works. I'm confused now. I'm confused and confuddled. We didn't have... That was only like halfway, but it looks like a full tank of this. You only use part of it. I guess that does kind of make sense, because we're not putting the grain and stuff in. It should sort of use up more of it, but it doesn't actually tell you anywhere that that's what it's going to do. It just kind of makes it vanish into thin air and then just leaves me feeling all confused and wondering where it's all gone. And it doesn't make any sense, and I don't like it. Right, anyway, enough of that. The race over here. It's very nearly time to go. We're just going to put this last little bit of straw in for the cows. We can't actually put it in anywhere except inside the barn, can we? I don't think we can. There's no other areas that it will let us do this. We've got to do this particular bit from right inside the barn in here. Oh no, you had to tip it into the feed trough, didn't you? I'm pretty sure that's what we had to do. Because I did try sort of stretching the thing right over the feed trough, and I don't think it worked. Well, that's actually my timer to say it's time to go. So I spent way too long doing other stuff, and I didn't actually get to do what I wanted to do today. So I'm sorry about that. Yeah, if I tip it over there, is that going to work? It does work. There we go. Right, I will fill up the rest of that in a minute. Right, while I'm rushing back over here, my question for this week, we just go into here, and we want to go into the baling technology. Do you want me to use the Arcusin 812, the three bale Arcusin? I will probably just stack the bales in threes in the fields and then load them onto a trailer and bring them back. Or do you want me to use the bigger Arcusin for the 16 bales? So do you want me to use the 16 bale one or the three bale one when I get a baler, which will be that one? When I eventually get the baler and we start doing some baling, which Arcusin would you like me to use? Would you like me to do it all with the single trailer, or would you like me to be doing a load of work out in the field using the trailer and all of the rest of that? Or would you like it nice and simple? We'll bring it back with this. We can stack it up. That thing is a beauty, by the way. I really like that one. But yeah, it's your vote. It's your game. Head into the comments section. Let me know which ones, which you prefer and why. And yeah, that can also be today's topic of discussion. See if you can't persuade other people to vote for the one you voted for, but don't forget to mouse over in the top right hand corner so that you can actually cast your vote. Now then, I am going to try and spin this around in here, because we don't want to be tipping it into our feed trough, do we? So we want to spin it round and try and get it tipped in as far as we possibly can. Turn the lights on in here. There we go. We can light the cows up. Look at that. Beautiful. Hang on. And I always like to get the best possible angle. And I go forward a little bit more. I'm going to tip it right all over the cow, aren't we? Look at this. We're out of the way, cow. It's not going to let us tip now. Yeah, we're a little bit too close to the trough. Right, perfect. Okay, there we go. If you've enjoyed this episode, then please head down below and give us a like. And if you really enjoyed it, please tell your friends all about me. Get them to come and watch as well. That would be awesome. Tomorrow, we will start our soybean harvest. And, well, we'll at least do that field just out there. But because we've got all beans, we're not going to have any straw to deal with this time. And, yeah, that's it. So, thank you very much for watching. Oh, hang on. There was something else that I was thinking of. Oh, can't remember now. It'll come to me after I've finished. Oh, well. Yeah, until next time, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye, and see you later.